I'm Green Deane, and welcome back to my 26th video here on EatTheWeeds.com. Today we're going to talk about a pretty common plant here in the south, but it also ranges all the way up to Michigan and to the Rockies, and that's called the Yucca filamentosa. We're going to look at a couple of photos, and then we're going to head out in the field and spend a lot of time in the field today. Let's go do it. One of the nice things about the Yucca filamentosa is that it's almost impossible to misidentify, and that goes back to its name, which is means filament producing. All the leaves are constantly shedding threads off their sides, plus it has a needlepoint tip. Those things combined with the basal rosette make you very, very sure that when you look at this plant, you've got the right plant. Now the yucca blossoms are just this wonderful sign that the spring and summer is here, and in all kinds of guidebooks they say they're edible and tasty and put them in your salads and all that. I'll tell you the truth, I've never been into a yucca blossom that I could eat raw. They're either been gave me a stomach ache, or they are very bitter in the mouth, give you a throat ache. I have just not run into one, so I always cook them. Your mileage may vary, but just a word to the wise. We're out on the Seminole Wakaiba hiking trail, and we're looking at a yucca, the base of a yucca filamentosa. And of course it's in blossom right now next to this fence post, and it has this lovely, lovely raceme of blossoms on it. The Yucca filamentosa grows from Florida, north to Michigan, maybe Canada. It grows from the Rockies east to the Atlantic. It has a lot of relatives in the southern southwest. It's called filamentosa because a lot of threads come off the leaves, and these threads can be made into an excellent cordage. That's in fact the needle tip. There's a tip on each leaf that's just like a needle, and you can actually strip with these your knife backwards and make all kinds of cordage, and you actually use the tip of the leaf to sew with. It's an extremely versatile plant, and let's start actually with what you can't see, and that's the roots. The Indians took the roots, boiled them, and pounded them up, made a soap out of them. With the roots uncooked, they pounded them up and made them into poultices for sprains and wounds. The stalk, when it's young, can be cooked like asparagus, it's in a change of water. And when it has fruit, the fruit can be boiled, and then the meat of the fruit taken out and eaten. The boiled seeds are taken out of the boiled fruits, and then you coarsely chop up the seeds and boil the seeds again until they're soft, and they can be eaten like a vegetable. And of course the flowers are edible as well. Now a lot of books, matter of fact all books, will tell you these flowers can be eaten raw or cooked. It's been my experience that these give me a stomachache when they're raw, because all you eat is the blossom part. You don't eat the any greenery that's on them. But still, they tend to bother my stomach, although actually I got brave again and tried them for another time. Maybe this time it'll be a work for a charm on me. So it's a lovely plant. By the way, this stalk can grow up to some 25 feet and be a couple of inches through. And as you can notice, there's quite a few of them right along here. And this is a pasture. which tells us that, and they're not growing in the pasture, which tells us that when they're young, they're probably quite edible for the cows and horses who live here. Let's look at a couple of things also I want to mention. If you're in a survival situation, you have what's here is the end of the leaf, which is very, very sharp. You can actually notch this, put it in a piece of bait, and put it on the string and use it for a hook. And here we have last year's stalk, a couple of them, very dry. As a matter of fact, there's two of them over here. Last year's stalks. This is called yucca wood. And from a survival point of view, or if you ever need it, this wood is the has the lowest kindling temperature of any wood. So if you were going to make a bow drill set to make fire with, this is the wood that you'd want to use for your drill, because it's the one that will light the quickest and the easiest. So we have an all-around plant, the Yucca filamentosa. On the sweet side. I might take some of these home and give them a try. I've had a few requests to show more preparing a wild food, so what I have here is a plate of yucca blossoms, and I'm going to make a stir fry out of them. Now to prepare them, I'm going to take the blossom and snip off the end so I have nothing but petals, and then I'm going to put them into boiling water for about 12 minutes, put them in there and reduce the heat.
and before I stir fry them. And unless you like the extra protein, get rid of all the insects first.
Here in Eat the Weeds, we itemize. So let's itemize this right while we're here in the field. First of all, identification. Well, we've got a basil rosette of long leaves that are tipped by a very sharp spine. And of course, the relative Spanish bayonets have got even stronger spines. We've got a long stalk that can be up to 25 feet and a couple inches through, which is then topped by some creamy yellow-white blossoms. Time of year. Well, end of May, first of June here in Central Florida, and of course it's getting to be about 90 degrees in the daytime. So it's blooming when it's warm, because therefore it will probably be a month or two for you up in more than northern climes. Environment. Again, we can see the environment here. It likes it dry, but not arid. We have a lot of rain here in Central Florida, and it does quite well through all that rain as long as it can drain. So it likes to be dry, but not arid. Nice environment for it. And lastly, of course, method of preparation. While there's nothing done, you take the stalk, can be, when it's very, very young, you know, we're talking small, can be chopped up and cooked like asparagus. The blossoms can be eaten cooked or raw, but remember my warning about eating them raw. The fruits can be cooked, and then the meat of the fruit taken out and eaten. Then the seeds that have been boiled with the fruit come out, chop up those seeds and boil them again until they're soft and make a nice vegetable out of them. So very, very versatile plants as far as food and usage. And that's the itemizing of the Yucca filamentosa. One more thing. When you go to a grocery store, you'll often see a yucca root for sale. The yucca root in the grocery store is not a yucca, it's actually a cassava, and it has nothing to do with the yucca that we saw today. As a matter of fact, the roots of the plant we saw today taste like soap. Don't even try to eat them. So that's a big misnomer. People think they see the yucca root in the grocery store, therefore the yucca root in the wild must be edible. Not at all. Two totally different plants, two totally different families, just happen to have the same name. Now, if you want to read more about the yucca, go to eattheweeds.com. I've got a good essay there, blog on there on yuccas, and about 100 other edible plants on top of that. So this is Green Deane. Thanks for joining me on my 26th video here. And until next time, I want you to think green, eat green. Well, not this, I guess. Or not that either. You could eat that, though. Toodles.